Also, how do you I wonder how do you stay so precise when making tattoos? Because one single, it's not even, there's no, literally no scope of error. It's such a precision job. Like, you have to get every dot of ink right. So what, how do you get into that mode? Because you can't just casually draw something on someone and make it a permanent mark.
Yeah, it only comes with time. Like if you, a lot of people learn from me and I teach them. And what they expect is most of the people that after 4 months of training, they will be as good as me or any other senior artist after 4 months, which is not the case. We can only teach them the basics of the machine and you know how the needles work, what are the voltage and everything, basic or technical. But the precision only comes with time. So it's not like the first very first day or in the very first year I was drawing portraits. No, I was doing basic script names and you know the generic tribal designs, and you become better and better in lines. You know you can pull off a line in a row and you can smoothly shade it. And when you become better in medium and small tattoos, then you graduate to big tattoos. What a lot of people want right now is they want to finish a course and they want to do full sleeve, but it does not come like that. You have to be good in small and then medium tattoos, and you should be able to do medium-sized clean tattoos before graduating to a bigger piece or a portrait or something. So for me, it took me 5 years. After 5 years, I attempted my first portrait tattoo, which I specialize in. For the first 5 years, I was just doing basic names and all, stars and angels and you know the basic infinity kind of designs. But that teaches you a lot, because the smaller tattoos, you can see the flaws much better. If the line is from here to there, it's a big piece like this piece. If I don't know if you can see, but you know, you even if this is a Japanese design, and there are no law, there are flaws in Japanese tattoos, but you know, if I make this flower a little different, it won't matter to you. It will still be a flower. So doing these kind of things and analyzing after, you know, after the session that you could have done this better or you missed out this or something. The clients, they never know. But you know that you could have done better. The clients are always happy, thankfully. But I'm never happy with my work. People are, you know. That's why I'm on your podcast or any other show. But after every tattoo, I always contemplate that or analyze my work that yeah, I could have done this better, darker, lighter, more contrast. So I'm never satisfied, but that's how you learn. So it's all practice and years of experience and constantly doing that thing. It's like muscle memory. You know, some things you instinctively do without, you know, it's like a reaction to something. So it's all repetition and muscle memory, I would say.
Amazing. It's honestly like to get a look inside the mind of a very accomplished tattoo artist. I've always wondered, like, how do these guys not mess up? How do they not, their hands don't tremble?
There is no artist who can say that you know they have done perfect tattoos from day one. Everyone in there, like you see this tattoo, this which is my first tattoo, the lines are all blown out, they're fading at some places. That's how we learn. They're not all consistent lines. I mean, yeah, earlier work and later work, if you see, you know, you can always make out the difference. So no one is born with it. You know, they call it like talent. Talent is nothing. No one is born with a tattoo machine in their hand and doing perfect tattoos or in any other field also. They work hard, and then when they become better at it over the years, people say that this guy is talented. But there is nothing like talent. If I won't put hard work, I won't be able to do it. So it's all hard work, and talent is like nothing. Anyone can do it. Even if you want to do something and give you 100%, 110% more than others to it, you will be able to do anything. Like Elon Musk, he's not a rocket scientist, but before NASA, he landed the rocket back on Earth, and NASA has been doing it since decades. So it's all, you know, your willpower, perseverance, and what do you want to do achieve in life.